Okay, this is my task two. Perform a PCV and total solids or total proteins rather. For my supplies, I have gloves, which I'm putting on right now. I have a purple tap tube or EDTA tube with blood. I have two microhematocrit tubes, some clay, and my microhematocrit capillary tube reader. So, and let me show you what I got. So that's what I was saying. I have the purple top tube, which I'm going to invert a couple of times to make sure that it's properly mixed. My two microhematocrit tubes, clay, and my reader. So the first thing I'm going to do is, like I said, invert it a couple of times. And I'm going to kind of put my finger on the end of the microhematocrit tube, and I'm going to just fill it to about 70 to 90%. And it's just going to kind of fill on its own as soon as I touch it to the blood and kind of invert it a little bit. It's slowly going. Wipe it off before I stick it into the clay. I want to make sure you got a good seal in there. I'm going to do the same thing with the other tube. Alright, and the next thing I'm going to do is spin them down the centrifuge, and I'll show you how we do that. Alright, this is our microhematocrit centrifuge, but it does not work. I told you this in my email. But you can see here, there's six, actually, places that we can put the microhematocrit tubes. And how you would do this is, if I were to use this one, you see the little clay down here at the bottom, I would put the clay spinning outward. Say if we had multiple of different patients doing PCVs at the same time, we would just make sure that we know which one is our particular patient is in. Like say, I'm gonna put mine in, say, number one, with the clay facing outward, and then number six, because, and again, the clay facing outward. And because I'm doing one and six, the reason being is so that way it's balanced. Or I could do two and five. And again, the clay would be facing outward. And then I'll put my cap on, lock it, close it, and then I would turn it to 3 minutes, which has a little dial right here, and it would just spin until 3 minutes. But, like I said, this one does not work. The motor is shot. So, I'm going to put it in our big hematocrit tube or blood tube spinner, or centrifuge. I'm going to show you how we do that. Okay, so, I'm going to show you how we do our ghetto rigged PCV centrifugation. So, we have our two microhematocrit tubes, and we've got two just regular vacuate tubes, no additive or anything like that. So essentially what we're going to do, I put them in their separate things so that way they're not like banging around in there because it is glass, and I'm just smashing against each other. So I just put them in their own separate one. So we have them in their little tubes, just to kind of hold them. Don't get lost down here in the tubes. And I'm going to put them balanced on either side of each other. Make sure that I don't have any other tubes in here. Throw off my balance. Alright. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm only going to put it on 3,000 RPM for about 3 minutes. Any longer than that, you wind up with hemolysis, and you wind up centrifuging the clay right out the bottom, and then you wind up with the bloodiness. So we're just gonna let this spin for about 3 minutes, and I'll show you how we read the PCV and or the packed cells, and how we do the total solids or the total proteins. All right, so we got our hematocrit tube spun down. And remember what I was saying was if you spin it for a little too fast, you'll wind up with the clay spinning out of it, and you wind up with a little bit of a bloody mess. Well, that's what happened with one of them, which is a good thing when we had two tubes. So we're just going to read the one tube. And have to flip it a little bit to get it out of there. And so you can actually see where it serums here. The little buffy coat, and then all the packed cells at the bottom. So, let me get you situated. So what we do, we're going to take the, from the top of the clay at the bottom to the top of the serum. I'm just going to measure where it is, and I've measured about 64%, and which is really good actually. And the next thing we're gonna do is take my little flood, and I'm gonna kind of etch it just above the buffy coat, just so that way makes it a little easier to break. Say that, and we'll see. Next thing I want to do is just kind of snap it. I'm going to try to get some of this out of here. See if I can't get a little dropper just to kind of put some air through there. Next thing you want to do is just kind of make sure that there's no little bits of glass on there, and you're going to take the hematocrit or the the refractometer and just kind of take it to the light and just kind of look at it. Total solids. I'm rating it about 11. I'm going to get my preceptor to double check for me. Dr. Crawford. I rated it about an 11. What do you think? thing we're going to do is wash it off. We're going to actually make note of that in the patient's chart. First, PCA was, we said, 64%. And total solids or total protein was about 11 grams per deciliter. So that's what we write down. Now we're going to clean it off. And then a little bit of distilled water. And then I'll wipe it up. And then we're going to put everything back where it goes. That's how you do PCV and total solids, total proteins, and record it into the patient's chart.